אנחנו רוצים לדבר עכשיו עם מישהו שהשתתף בהפגנות לשם בדוי, קווין. הלו קווין.
היי.
It was one of the most violent days in Hong Kong. You've been there. What happened there?
Like we have many people, at least thousands of hundreds of people gathered together, even though the police disapproved the protests yesterday, but still at least six districts of Hong Kong were gathering with different people. And among that, the most serious clash will be wars starting in Chuan, Tuen Mun and Sha Tin. In three areas, the police shoot the real bullets. And according to the press release from the police force yesterday, they expressed that they have shoot six real bullets. And in one bullet, they even shoot close to the protester, in only one step between the protester and the police officer. And during that time, the police officer is supposed to have another less death weapon, that is the beanbag shot, but he still choose to use the real bullet guns. And the bullet, it's penetrated inside his left lung, and his whole left lung is collapsed. And he was in an emergency situation, and the police stopped the first aider to help him for 3 minutes. And after they saw him keep bleeding from his heart area, so they allowed the first aider to save him. And after the first aider saved him, they also arrested the first aider. And at the same time, the police keep using different kinds of violence behavior, unless they smash the face of the protester. You can see from all the Hong Kong media, and also many Hong Kong media journalists were being harassed. They are also being pushed during the interview, and some of the police even shoot the real bullets in front of them. And luckily, they fought like they covered themselves in a shell, so they were not being shot by the police. And
Kevin, it seems like crazy. A scary situation.
Yes, it's really bad, because the police, they don't care who you are, even though you are foreigners. They will still arrest you as long as you are wearing black and you look young and you were present in the protest area. So this is quite serious. And like you can see that now the government and the police force, the management of the police force, they don't really care. They just want to maintain the safety and the security of Hong Kong. So they use different kinds of means to maintain and suppress the political parties and all the organizations and protests in Hong Kong. As you can see on the videos right now, all the police is like they were taking drugs and they're really out of control. And
but it's look both really of the both sides using violence.
Yes, but at the very beginning, we know that the police, they prepared and they have been hiding themselves in different areas of each district the night before, and that's why all the people, they know that it's gonna happen. But at the very beginning, they did nothing until the police came out to shoot them, to use the pepper spray to spray them.
However, Kevin, we know that there was a ban on rallies this day.
Yes, we know that, because we know that it's a national day yesterday, and we know that the government wanted to suppress everything in order to restore the security of Hong Kong. But I can tell you, the reason why we're still going out to protest is not just because of protest. We would like the government to really, really directly and face-to-face respond to the five demands that we have been urging for, including the establishment of the independent commission to have the inquiry about the misbehavior and misconduct of the police. And we really, really want to have the universal suffrage of the chief executive elections and the parliaments in Hong Kong. Because we know that this is the thing that has been guaranteed during the 80s between the UK government and the Chinese government in the 80s before we has been handed over back to China. But then since 2 years ago, the Chinese government already mentioned that one country, two system, I mean the Sino-English Joint Declaration.
Kevin, will you continue to protest?
Ken, you want to know about the situation?
No, we want to know if we will continue, if the protest will continue.
Yes, we will continue. The protest will continue.
Okay.
Because the government didn't respond to us for anything, even though they have a small discussions with 150 people to have a talk a few days ago. But still, Carrie Lam used crazy violence to suppress us. And it's different from before, because Now the younger generation, they are very determined. They are not like the older generations. And we are really fighting for what we want. And as long as if the government it's not going to respond to us, the protest will keep going.
Yes, Kevin, loud and clear. Thank you.
Okay, thank you very much.